In this video, we're going to take a look at how we can create a section view in an Autodesk Inventor drawing. We're going to look at several different examples. First, I'll start with a simple full section. I have a top view of this part, and I want to generate a full section front view. I'll select the Section View tool here on the Place Views tab. The first step is to select the view. Then I want to select the points to define my section. I'm going to track off of the midpoint of this feature. I don't want to click right on the end because that will put my section arrow right on top of the part. So I'll track out to the left a little bit here. Then I'll go all the way across the part to the right. Then I can select right click, then continue. Then I can decide which direction I want my section view to go. Then click to place it. As you can see, it automatically labels the section arrows and the view itself, and it automatically adds in the hatch pattern for me. I can even project this into an isometric view if I would like to see the sectioned isometric view. Next, we'll look at an aligned section view. It works very similarly, just an extra click or two. I'll select the section tool, then the view, and then I'm going to track off of my shape here. Snap to the center, and then I'll project across this circular shape here as well. Right click and continue, and there you can see my aligned section view. Next, we'll look at an offset section view. Again, very similar steps, just additional picks. I'll choose the section view tool, then the view, then I am going to track off of one of my features here. So I'll draw through this circle, then I'll track off of this circle, then across my part, then right click and continue. See that one more time here. Section, select the view, track off of the center here, go past, track off the next, then right click and continue. And then once more, I've got another offset section at a different location. When creating an offset section, we typically do not display this edge that appears from the section arrow changing direction. To remove this line, you can simply select it, right click, and then turn off the visibility check mark. Now we have a proper offset section. Finally, we'll take a look at an example of sectioning an assembly. I'll select my section tool again, then the view. Once more, I'll track off of the shape, select my points, right click and continue. So here you can see I have multiple components, and as a result, different angles of hatch patterns. I can select my hatch pattern, right click and edit if I would like to choose a different pattern or if I would like to adjust the angle differently. I can also remove a component from the section itself. Oftentimes, components like fasteners will not be sectioned in an assembly view. In this case, I'm going to take this rod running through the middle here, and I don't want this piece to be sectioned. In my browser over here, I'll locate the section view. I'll click the plus next to it, the plus next to the assembly. I'll find that component. I'll right-click on it, point to section participation, and set it to none. Now you can see that that part is no longer sectioned. I'll go ahead and create a projected view off of this one so we can get a better look at that. I'll adjust this and make it shaded. There we go. So there you can see part of the assembly is sectioned and part of it is not. That concludes this look at creating section view drawings in Autodesk Inventor.